room of expressionless faces staring blankly at my head, so devoid of meaning there must be evil intent. Doctor this and doctor that and doctor what's it, who's just passing and thought he'd pop in to take the piss as well. I'm burning in a hot tunnel of dismay, my humiliation complete as I shake without reason and stumble over words that have nothing to say about my illness, which anyway amounts only to knowing that there's no point in anything because I'm going to die. And I'm deadlocked by that smooth, psychiatric voice of reason which tells me there is an objective reality in which my body and mind now one. But I am not yet, and never have been. Dr. This writes it down, and Dr. That heard a sympathetic murmur, watching me, judging me, smelling the crippling failure oozing from my skin, my desperation clawing an all-consuming panic drenching me as I gaze in horror at the world and wonder why everyone is smiling and looking at me with secret knowledge of my aching shame. Irrescrutable doctors, the sensible doctors, way out doctors who you'd think were fucking patients if you weren't sure who's otherwise. Ask the same questions, put words in my mouth, offer chemical cures to congenital anguish and cover each other's asses until I want to scream for you. The only doctor who ever touched me voluntarily, who looked me in the eye, who laughed at my gallows humour spoken in the voice in the newest of me, who took the piss when I shaved my head, who lied and said it was nice to see me, who lied and said it was nice to see me. I have reached the end of this dreary, repugnant tale of a sentence turned in an alien carcass and lumped by the malignant spirit of the moral majority. I have been dead for a long time. This is not a world in which I wish to live.
Patient number 4260B. Psychoanalysis by Dr. Malone. Symptoms: not eating, not sleeping, no sex drive, in despair, wants to die. Diagnosis: pathological grief. Have you made any plans?
Take an overdose, slash my wrist, and I'm gonna hang myself.
All those things together?
It couldn't possibly be misconstrued as trying to help.
It wouldn't work.
Of course it would.
It wouldn't work. You'd start to feel sleepy from the overdose. Then you wouldn't have the energy to cut your wrists.
I'd be standing on a chair with me for rather less.
Sterily, 50 milligrams. Insomnia worsened. Severe anxiety. Increase in suicidal thoughts, plans and intentions. Discontinued following hospitalization. If you were alone, do you think you might harm yourself?
I'm scared, am I?
Could that be protective?
It's fear that keeps me away from the train track. I just hope to God that death is the end. I feel like I'm 80 years old. I'm tired of my mind just wants to die.
That's a metaphor, not reality.
It's a simile.
That's not reality.
It's not a metaphor. And even if it was, the defining feature of a metaphor is that it's real.
You are not 80 years old, are you? Patient discharged into the care of the community on arrival of acutely psychotic patient in emergency clinic who was in greater need of a hospital bed. Patient readmitted due to relapse.
Do you despise all the happy people, is it just me?
I don't despise you. It's not your fault. You're ill.
I don't think so.
No?
No. I'm depressed. Depression's anger. It's what you did. Who was there? Who are you blaming?
And who are you blaming?
Myself.
Oh. What's happened to your arm?
I cut it.
That's a very immature, attention-seeking thing to do. Did it give you relief?
No.
Did it relieve the tension?
No.
Did it give you relief? Did it give you relief?
No.
I don't understand why you did that.
Then ask.
Did it relieve the tension? Can I look?
No.
I'd like to look to see if it's infected.
No.
I thought you might do this. Lots of people do it. It relieves the tension.
Have you ever done it? No. Didn't think so. Bath, you fucking insane and sensible. And wherever you read it, it doesn't relieve the tension. Why don't you ask me why? Why did I cut my arm?
Would you like to tell me?
Yes.
Then tell me.
Ask me why.
Why did you cut your arm?
Because it feels fucking great. Because it feels fucking amazing.
Can I look?
You can look, but you can't touch it.
And you don't think you're ill? Patients refused all further treatment. 100 aspirin and one bottle of Bulgarian Cabernet Sauvignon, 1986. Patient woke in a pool of vomit and said, sleep with the dog and ride slow, please. Severe stomach pain. No other reaction.